Assalamu alaikum. Today we will learn how to make a Microsoft form using an official email. On behalf of my group, Formative Assessment MLWA, Track 1, Group 9, thanks to my dearest colleagues, Dr. Akram, Dr. Basim, Dr. Osama, Dr. Salwa, Dr. Asma, an outstanding leader, and me, Noha Rashid. Thanks for meticulous supervision of Professor Dr. Jihan Saleh. When we sign in using an official email, we will press on this button to display all the application we can use. We will concentrate today on the form. When we press on it using an internet connection, we will find here the list of previously made Microsoft forms. We will choose new quiz, new form, and then we will enter here the title. Let's name it Formative Assessment Test. You can enter a description here. It is not obligatory for learning, for example. And then we will press on Add New. Choice here for MCQ question. This is a previously made question, can be copied from a Word file, and then we can select this one. We can press a new one here and take the stem of the question to be written here. We use 5 options according to the newly settled standard. We can enter here 10 liter, can enter here another distractor, 2 liters, 5 liters, and so. This calculation will be, this will be one of these answers. Okay. And you will press here again, and we will 5 choices. I think it is enough. It can be 4. Required question, we can press on it if we want the student should, want student that he should answer on it first. As all the question will be answered, we can be not press or use this option. Multiple answers will be used if you have 2 choices can be correct. When we press here, shuffle option, it will be used if you want that your student when answering the form not to look to the side. So one person will have 10, 2, 5, and so, and the other will have another. Shuffle question can be pressed, but when you use this option, kindly not put here A, B, C, D, it will be shuffled also. So better if you want to shuffle question to enter the distractors without numbering or bullying it. A drop down, it will be an arrow will appear, and I will display it here by using the preview. This is the drop. I don't prefer this option actually, because in exam it is better to have all the answers displayed on front of you. Add branching, if you want that the person who will be answering answer question number 1 at first, then question number 5 and question number 4, it can be used in certain situations. It's up to you. We should find here that it is a correct answer. Correct answer will appear here as an a tick. It will be added later. Then let's start another one, which is text. This option can be used if you want that your student will answer a short essay, mention different components. As I am a physiologist, so I'll put a question from my curriculum, different components body fluid It can be used, but actually the answer will be not automatically corrected. So it can be used, but up to limit. I don't prefer it actually. Then let's add another one, which is rating. It can be used when we collect opinions about something. For example, what's your feedback about this ML web? We can use another one, which is DAPE, but it is not used in medicine, I think. Likert, it's used for survey. How did you find working in your team? It can be used, I think. We should start with strongly agree. The second option will be agree. Third one, neither agree or disagree. Neutral, I mean. Third one, disagree. The last one will be strongly disagree. First statement, working in the team has improved my communication skill. Second statement, it was challenging. And so, okay, let's display our one. This is the first question. It can be shuffled, not the same sequence I entered. This is a space for short essay question. This is for the feedback, not to be used in exams. This is for the feedback, okay? Submit will be pressed by the student after answering the question. Let's have a look on an important point, which is setting. Setting, when you press in it, you can choose who can fill in this form. Anyone can respond, but I don't prefer this one because we are using official email, so it is better to be people in your organization. Record name is very important. When we display the Excel sheet, you will find the name of the student. One response, it can be used if this is a summative class, a summative exam, or if it is a formative, it can be not chosen to allow the student to have multiple responses. Specific people, if we press on it, we will find the same. Record name or one. I prefer only people in my organization. Options for responses, accept responses, this will be a must to be used. Start date, if you have a certain date, you can, for example, you can choose certain date here. It will be open at the date you choose. End date also, after that time, student cannot submit or cannot open the exam. Shuffle question, it can be used. Response receipt, allow receipt of response after submission. If this is a feedback, get mail notification. It is noisy, but it can be chosen. When you finish, you can press on a chair. This is for response, only people in my organization. You can copy it and send it by email. If you want to collaborate with a colleague, you can choose this one, get a link to view or edit. When you send it to the instructor, sharing with you the course. Okay, let's have a look on previously formed one. This one, this was made previously. This is the responses. You will find it is automatically calculated the average time to complete, and this is the result. This was my project in FAMER, and this is the response of my student. For example, for the first statement, my project developed my problem-solving skills. About 36% of students find that it their opinions are strongly agree. About 53 or 54% found that it is they are agreed. They are they choose agree option, and only 10% neither neutral, neither agree or disagree. This is very important point, which when we use feedback, you can have open-ended question to be used by your student, and you will find that they will write their opinion in a reflective way, which is amazing. If we have a look on another form made by me, for example, a quiz for a student. I have 64 responses. This was the question, and this was the answer of the student. In this question, about 58 out of 64 answered it correctly. The color here is automatically chosen by the form. And I have found that most of the students choose the right one. And this is the other options. In another question, most of the students, but last percent, choose the right answer. They were 52 students only out of 64. And so you can find here the analysis of each question. You can omit the difficult one, or you can concentrate more on the points displayed or examined in this difficult question if you want. When you press on Excel sheet, when it will be opened, sorry for this delay. It will display the student name and the total points they gained. And then in each question, which is the answer they choose. And every question can be here, find that each one, 0.5, it was a half degree on each question. This student take the right one. So she gained 0.5 from the question number one, 0.5 from the question number two, and so all the question can be display answers can be displayed here, which answer. Okay. Thanks for watching, and I hope it was beneficial for you. Thank you.